What is that SRP? It's a state-of-the-art protocol. We have a couple different styles. We have real friends that we're running. We have DPI. We have how many IOPS each necessarily trying to keep the volume at one time. So the important part for me is to say, let's not do any harm. So if we're doing a little bit of harm, let's try to avoid that or minimize it as much as possible. So when we're in the car, let's say we have one drug doing 1 hour at a time. And we need to lose the performance on the battery that they picked up just a small amount. It's right around 30,000 miles per second. When we go into a single run, single drug, 1 hour at a time. We have to carry some of those guys out 32 hours in the same way. So we actually we see a little bit of improvement in factor maybe we can take it over a little bit and maybe more efficient to just get it cleaned already, which I think is a great move, really exciting. But we start to see a little better support scalability next year. We've got 4 threads running once again, single aisle to 32 hours. So the threads are a little bit of a picture for that. 4 threads are we went from being just below 100,000 miles per second up to about 150,000 miles. Pretty good, I'd say. I'm pretty happy with that. I'm talking about that. We get 2 threads. We get a little bit better when we get to 8 threads. We've got more than 200,000. We're keeping busy. Then once we hit 16 threads, 32 hours, and we've gotten to the point where we're actually able to throw almost 300,000 miles per second. At the point, this is all for about 2637. So, we've had almost a year go by. I tried to actually get 3 threads running so I could do some more up to date and testing to see what else is happening with scalability. There's been a lot of work on the block data and a little bit of the scalability program. But it's pretty much at this point of what's going to be fun. There's a full core system type of thing. But at some point, we've already saturated table salt. We've thrown away, we're super saturated. We have some pretty good ways to go out of time. I think there's more to be able to be done here. But that's a whole future work. Another piece that we've done in the past year is large IA support. We had a real problem for the Mitsubishi where we would actually send down the large IA to our special components. There's a number of reasons for this. But the big thing is there are large target factors that have really high per request overhead. They do really well. This is especially important when you start doing random workloads. Basically, if you're giving them 1 megabyte request, you give them a full random workload across the entire run, you get maybe 40% at best of what you actually get out of the CPIC or the write stream for that bit. But if you give them 4 megabyte hours at that point, now you're back to where you're getting about 95% of the serial in the CPIC or write stream. That's a really big win. Especially in the car world, when we're running large data centers, large computers, large plants, and electric power systems, all IO ends up becoming random. So, 18,000 times, that's a big update to the system. But again, unless we like to send out 1 megabyte request, so we can really make this case work really well, that's going to be a real benefit to us. But it's really hard to get there with the whole issue. Memory fragmentation on the system means that we really don't get to our 1 megabyte request. And we end up with we have this 255 limit in the description. We'll talk more about that. That means we can only get 255 pages at that point, which means we don't write that nice 1 megabyte request. It's probably around 200 stack size. We might be able to read one by right. We're not breaking that up into one that's 1,040. Another one is 4 kilobyte request. And that is the information that we have around it. You can see that a 1 meg request is sitting on 128 KB to this KB. So that's really nice that the disk can actually do pretty well for 1 KB to 128 KB request. Now, if you break this up into 1040 or 4K, you can now break it up into disk, especially if you're in the capacity. You break it up into 127.5 KB request. There's a lot of benefits for us to get this moving. And so we're coming to find the problem because SRP has these 2 memory restrictors. We've got this direct restrictor, which, hey, I only have one of these to be taken for presence, so we have this 2 memory. We have another part that's indirect, which we have a header table, which is here for the table we can move. And here's all these restrictors that say this part of the input list comes from this section. So those scattered atoms. And SRP spec said, hey, you know, you can do it on the vendor uptake. You can test that at the time. You don't have to send it. And you don't have to make people that have to do it. Just go ahead and send it over to them. And, you know, that's great. However, a lot of people didn't get the spec for it. And didn't realize that, oh, that can actually just be a parser thing. We don't actually have to send my telephone to them. And the target at that point is not sending the entire directive. The target's going to be the entire directive. Over the table, and now we're going to actually walk the table to the RDA to actually get the final product. Unfortunately, if you're going to expect the price, no target is actually working with that. So, actually, there is one target out there that I'm very good for, and that's the one commercially out of it. I'm going to do a couple of weeks before I actually have that support. But everyone has to require you to actually send all your data to the table, and the script is in the command. So, company has to keep it down. All I can do is think. Yeah. 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 And then absolutely, because they were integrity to caution. Yeah. I've got this IO that I can't actually click and play. Yeah. I can tell the IO. And the problem there is that that's not right. They were sort of like they were at the bottom. Thank you. hardware that might be not supported for in the future. Like, it also wants to be able to take that. So what's going on right now? Broadband Access is continuing to work on making things that are really requested. Or if the router is really requested to do this around, unfortunately, I'm not going to have time to get into it. But this allows the disconnect a single target without having to mount the router and have to mount the disconnect for all of the vendors. It's really nice for sysadmins, especially between the testing and management, that can be able to face it every time and keep them in every department. We also have a timeline conversion system that will be defaults every 10 times 20 seconds. The default IB timeline is something around 60 seconds. So if 36 servers say, hey, that's a bad command, you didn't fix it, I'm not killing it. Thank you. I'm not sure what the purpose of the board is doing.